Golden Knights skated back into the series with two straight home wins. Chris Matthews and Deryk Engelland are here to talk postseason hockey with the best of seven series now tied at two games apiece.
Well, good evening. It is Monday, and that means it's time to face off with Deryk Engelland, the former Golden Knight, now Channel 8 hockey expert, joining us here tonight. Boy, what a weekend it was, Deryk. Crazy.
Yeah, it was awesome. The Fortress back at full capacity, and it didn't disappoint anyone. It was loud. I think louder than the finals the first year in there, so it was pretty amazing to see.
And to say, the Knights fall back 2-0 or 0-2 in the series, but they come back now, it's tied 2-2.
Yeah, they came home and did exactly what they needed to do. They needed to win every game at home and try to go out and sneak the next one out in Colorado.
Well, the Knights have certainly proven that they can play with supposedly the best team in the NHL. How are they getting this done?
Well, they're shutting down that top line. They're playing, Stone's line's been playing great against them, and other guys too on the ice, but to hold a team like Colorado to five shots in the second last game while they're trailing, and then four shots in the third being down is, it's hats off. That's amazing hockey right there.
They always say in various sports that defense wins you championships. Well, the Vegas Golden Knights throughout the regular season had the best defense, and now it's starting to show up here, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. It's, got a little away from it against Minnesota. Minnesota was able to put up shots, but like you said, you're going up against one of the best offenses in the league, and you're holding them to under 20 shots in a game. That's unbelievable.
Well, as a former Golden Misfit yourself here, how excited is it to see this Misfit line, Carlson, Riley, and Marchand? So they're starting to come around right now.
Yeah, it seems like they're back in that first year form. They're, Stoney's line's shutting down McKinnon's line right now. You know, that's a big job right in itself. And Marchie and them are picking up the score, and they're playing extremely well. They're clicking, and it's good to see.
Well, you had Braden McNabb coming off the NHL protocols, the COVID protocol, so he was back on the ice. Alex Pietrangelo. Talk about the defense, just those two players right there.
Yeah, Nabber, it's tough to replace a guy like that. He's a big, physical, kills penalties, sacrifices his body all over the ice, and, Petro's coming into his own. He's doing the same thing. He's all over the ice, it seems. You watch him and he's everywhere. So they're playing great for him, and the whole team, D-Core as a group, is playing great.
You know, we talk about the Vegas Golden Knights really from the very beginning to be able to roll those four lines out there. And it was neat to see Brown get a goal last night as Grubauer slid into the net there.
Yeah, no, they always work so hard. They're playing the right way. They're dumping pucks in. They're hitting guys. They're getting in all over everyone's face, and for them to get rewarded, it's huge. It's all the hard work, and they're battling every single night.
Well, it's going to be big tomorrow night when you speak of Knights. So what are the boys saying right now in the locker room with Game 5 coming up tomorrow?
I think just play the same way. You can't change your game going up there in Colorado. You don't have the line changes, matchups that you want, but if it's that next lineup, they got to do the job that other lines are doing right now.
Give me a prediction on tomorrow night's game.
Well, it's going to be a tight one. Knights, obviously, for sure. But could see it going maybe overtime.
Whoa, in overtime.
Yeah.
And the Knights win it.
Yeah.
Well, I like that. Let's hope it happens. All right, we're out of time. Tomorrow night, Denver, then back here Thursday in Las Vegas, 18,000 plus.